Dear students, in this video you are going to learn about the life cycle of Oudogonium. The Oudogonium is a green algae. You know that it is a class in Chlorophyceae. It is widely distributed in freshwater habitats such as ponds, lakes, tanks and rivers. It is found attached to the rock, wood or aquatic plants. That the mature thalli is free float on the surface of the water. So plants is a haploid gametophyte. It is an unbranched uniseriate filament consisting of a row of cylindrical cells. So these cells are longer than the threads. Some cells have a ring-like thickenings called cell caps. The apical cells is acute or rounded. The basal cells are filamentous, is modified into holdfast. That a holdfast has many finger-like projections called haptera, and it is lower end. So it anchors the filament on the substratum. The cell nature is eukaryotic and cylindrical. The protoplasm is contained a reticulate, chloroplast, a nucleus and a vacuole. The nucleus is a large and spherical, and it has one or few nucleoli. The chloroplast contain major pigments like chlorophyll A and B, carotene and xanthophylls. The reserve foods is starch. It is occurred in starch plates around the pyrenoids. The growth is take place by division of intercalary cells of the filament. The cell cap is formed one of the daughter cells in each divisions. So this is a peculiar features of Oudogonium. Now you can see the reproduction method of Oudogonium. It reproduces by three methods. They are vegetative, asexual and sexual reproduction. The vegetative reproduction takes place by fragmentation. What is mean by fragmentation? The filament is break into a small fragments of each of which then develop into a new plant. This is called a fragmentation. Now sexual reproduction takes place by zoospores, apnospore, acanids. So what is mean by zoospore? Zoospore are motile, uninucleate and multiflagellate. They are produced in zoosporangia. So the protoplast of the zoosporangium is contract and slightly become a beer shape. A colorless cytoplasmic dome developed at the one end of the protoplast. Then a ring of many flagella develops around the cytoplasmic dome. This type of flagella arrangement is called as a stephanotic type. So the resulting of multiflagellate cells called zoospore or stephanoton. So each zoospore contain reticulate chloroplast, a haploid nucleus and plenty of reserve food. As well as the zoosporangium rupsures the zoospore, comes out and swim in water and later germinate into a new gametophytic plant that is single in nature. This is about zoospore method. Another is Aplanospore. Aplanospore is a non-motile, non-flagellate spore are produced in Aplanosporangia. They are produced during the dry season. So during the favorable season, they germinate into a new plants. Sometimes the vegetative cell store plenty of reserve foods and secrete a thick wall around it. These thick wall cells is called as a achinate. During the favorable season, it germinate into the new filament. This is the method of Aplanospore. The sexual reproduction of Oodogonium is oogamous type. Now we are going to see about the sexual reproduction, that is oogamous type. So the male sex organ is called antheridium, female sex organ is called oogonium. The antheridium, the female organ is called oogonium, it contains haploid occur. You can see the figure that the Oodogonium filament that has oogonium and antheridium. Oogonium produce egg, antheridium produce sperm. So depending upon the distribution of sex organs, the, all the species of Oodogoniums are divided into two groups, that is Macranthus species and Nanandrus species. What is my Macranthus species? The antheridia and oogonia are produced in the normal filament. Some species are homothallic, or others called as a monoecious. A few are heterothallic, or others called as a diecious. So antheridium developed from apical or intracalary cells of the filament. The vegetative cell by repeated transfer division form a 20 to 40 antheridia. So the protoplasts of each antheridium divide into the two daughter protoplasts. So each protoplast metamorphose into a multiflagellate sperm. The sperms are released in water by the rupture of antheridial wall. The development of oogonium, it is developed from intracalary cells of the filament. The vegetative cells divide transversely into the lower supporting cell and upper oogonial initial cells. The oogonial initial cells enlarge in size and become round. So its protoplast contracts slightly to form an egg. So a colorless spot called receptive spot, it develops at the lateral side of the egg. The oogonial wall at the receptive spot forms a pore, or is called as a slit. So the released sperms are attracted towards the oogonium by chemostatic attraction. So one sperm enter to the oogonium through the spore and fuse with the egg at the receptive spot. As a result, it develop or it's form a diploid zygote. The zygote is secrete a thick wall around it form a zoospore. So this is about the sexual reproduction, the method of Macrandus species. This process, the fusion of the egg sperm, this process called as a fertilization. After the period, the rest of the protoplast of the zoospore divide meiotically into four haploid multiflagellate zoospore. Then the zoospore will germinate into a new filament. This life cycle is a haploidic type, so this will repeatedly happen in Oodogonium. So this is about the life cycle of Oodogonium. Thank you.